Hello ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this video. This video is all about retrograde Jupiter. So what exactly mean by retrograde Jupiter? When does the planet goes into retrograde? Let me tell you one thing. I was coming across one of the article which is called as retrograde planets in natal chart, which was written by Mr. Kavnag, where Kavnag stresses that what exactly mean by retrograde, when exactly planet retrograde happens. So for your indication, in your birth chart ideally you will see the symbol R next to that specific planet, then we can come into a conclusion that you have born during that specific axis, and during that point of time when you born, at your specific date of birth, time of birth and the place of birth, for that specific planet it has gone into the retrograde state. Alright, so what exactly mean by retrograde as per Mr. Kavnag? Mr. Kavnag is basically one of the great astrologer. So I'd like to tell you that retrograde, what he says on the subject retrograde. Retrograde essentially means the planet's energy is somewhat blocked externally. So those life areas that come within that planet domain are not so easily expressed. So that is what Mr. Kavnag, who is famous astrologer, talking about retrograde, has just blown my mind. The reason being, even I was having a little misunderstanding about this concept. What exactly is this retrograde? When this retrograde generally happens? What are the effects of it? So in this article, he has clearly given about what exactly retrograde means. Retrograde is nothing but that planet is making you think internally. It is making you to undergo certain lessons. It is making you to undergo certain challenges. Depending upon the planet's energy, whether it is Mars, Mercury, Jupiter, Saturn, or any, even the Rahu Ketu for that matter. So when that specific planetary period occurs, you need to internalize your own self. You need to go very deeper in terms of what is that planet is teaching you. What is that events concerning to that planetary period is teaching you. You need to go very deep inside, and you need to understand what are the lessons that it is teaching, and you need to learn those lessons to get blessings of that specific planet. So what if this is all based on the karma theory, where in which we all have born as a human life just because of some of the karmic debts that we have from the previous lives, and that is the main reason why we generally born as a human being. So in this, as per the karmic theory, so ideally, retrograde essentially means the planet's energy is somewhat blocked externally. That means the characteristics of this planet, the person cannot able to express outwards, express externally, because the life areas of this planetary energy is little blocked enough. That means when he exposed to the outer world, he cannot able to express it more easily. Okay, so during that point of time, he has to undergo certain. He has to reincarnate in this life to learn some deeper internal lessons. Please underline this keyword, deeper internal lessons regarding the areas of life ruled by that specific planet. He has to reincarnate in this life to learn some deeper internal lessons regarding the areas of the life ruled by that specific planet. Okay, so question, the person has asked me to talk on the retrograde Jupiter, but let me give you some solid understanding about retrograde. What does retrograde planet represents? And also you may experience a few challenges when you navigate a retrograde planet's life themes, at least until you work on those areas of life internally and can then enjoy them externally. That means you need to do some kind of internal, you need to focus on your life to understand what exactly this planet is teaching for me during this lifetime, during this planetary period, and you need to understand those lessons. Once you understand those lessons and you internalize that values in your system, in your mindset, then externally you can able to enjoy. For example, Jupiter is the planet of expansion. Jupiter is the planet of righteousness. Jupiter is the planet of values, optimism. Jupiter is the karaka for career as well as your power and authority. Jupiter is the karaka for finances as well. And Jupiter is karaka for marriage. So anything for that matter which gives you growth and expansion in your life, these things are all concerned with planet Jupiter. Alright, so and also Mr. Kavanagh stresses that the purpose of this process, the purpose of having the planet retrograde is not to punish you but to develop a deeper understanding and strength of traits associated with that retrograde planet. Will make you to understand, okay, come, okay, here is the time for me to teach you certain lessons. Here is something that you need to learn certain lessons. And you need to internalize that. You need to have deeper internal understanding. That's the keyword I want to use it. And also, it will uplift the strengths of that specific planet. For example, Jupiter is associated with knowledge and wisdom. So whenever Jupiter planetary period comes and it is retrograde, once you learn those lessons, it will uplift that areas, that traits of that specific planet. For example, your wisdom and your knowledge is exposed to the outer world. That happens just because of your having a retrograde Jupiter. So that is how you need to understand the retrograde of the of any specific planet. Alright, if at all you have retrograde Mercury, so which says that, it says that you need to have very well understanding about planets. Mercury, obviously, planet Mercury is nothing but it's a planet of thinking, communication, creativity, innovation, and something to do with your mindset. All right. So you need to do that internal understanding about your own mindset, about your communication, about your thought process, and then externally you can see the outer world. You can express that. You can able to experience that abundance and prosperity. All right. And also let me tell you, if at all you have retrograde Venus, Venus is associated with romance, Venus is associated with relationships and also all the things that you enjoy. If you born during the Venus retrograde, you may take the long road when it comes to love, creativity, beauty, pleasure, receiving peace and inner harmony. Venus is the karaka for general happiness. Venus is the karaka for comforts. So when it happens, whenever you have that Venus retrograde, then you may take the long road. That means you have to cross certain hurdles in order to get that love, that creativity, that beauty, that pleasure, that luxuries, that receiving, that peace and inner harmony. This is how you need to study the retrograde planets. And if at all you have retrograde Mars, Mars is the planet of fitness, personality, sexual drive, physical energy, vitality, good health, all that stuff, all that bravery, that courageousness, all these are significators of planet Mars. So if at all you have Mars retrograde, then you may face some issues related to energy, drive, ambition, autonomy, leadership and manifestation. All these things you need to cross all these hurdles during this in terms of gaining all this stuff which I have mentioned. You have to learn certain lessons, you have to face some conflicts, you have to face some internal misunderstandings, and then you can able to experience that abundance and prosperity. Alright, similar way, if at all you have Jupiter retrograde, Jupiter is considered as the most auspicious planet of all the nine planets, which we call as pro-Jupiter. So if at all Jupiter goes into retrograde in your birth chart, you may have some inner work to do around your abundance, your expansion, your luck and your generosity. So these are all the things in which you need to work. You need to work on improving your abundance, improving your expansion, improving your luck, improving your generosity. So that means what author is saying, that these things will not come to you naturally. You need to work for it, you need to put efforts to get that abundance, to get to have that expansion, to have that luck, to have that generosity. So you might be thinking that, okay, I have a Jupiter, strong Jupiter, and why is that I'm not able to get the desired results? The reason being, as Jupiter being the most auspicious planet of all the nine planets, you need to experience all these things to have that abundance and prosperity in your life. All right, and something to do with retrograde Saturn also, you have to undergo certain challenges and obstacles with regards to authority, responsibility, stability, success and boundaries. And also it talks about your maturity levels. So all these things are significators of planet Saturn, wherein with Saturn retrograde, you have to face some obstacles in terms of getting authority, responsibility, stability, success and boundaries. Alright, so this is something which I want to talk on the planet retrograde. with regards to Vedic astrology. I hope you enjoyed this video. In fact, this article which I'm referring to you is also an eye-opener for me, because this is one of the technical terms wherein which I keep seeing the retrograde planet. So what exactly is that is what I want to really learn, and I want to share that knowledge with you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. So let me know in the comment section what exactly you learned from this video, and also let me know if at all you need my astrological consultations. The link is mentioned in the description section. Do book for an astrological consultation, and so that I can able to help you with the birth chart analysis pertaining to your birth chart. Okay, so see you in the consultation. Bye for now.